What is the secret to creating that bore followed by the turf with your iron shots? Well, in today's live lesson, we're going to take Nick through exactly that, hopefully give you guys some useful things to help you pure your irons.
Yes, absolutely. Now, if you haven't subscribed already, you've been watching our content for a while and it's helping you, make sure you do subscribe and hit that notification bell. And if you want to knock 5 shots off your score, check out our free coaching series, 5 Shots Lower. It's in the description down below. So, Nick, thank you so much for making the journey.
It's all right, thanks for having me.
We're on the fairway, obviously the 14th at the Asprey. We've spoke about the irons, we've taken some videos already, but just for the people watching and for me again, what is it that we can help you with your irons?
Basically, I hit the ground a lot before the ball.
Okay.
I tend to push it to the right or slice it a lot as well.
There you go. That'll do. That's bad enough, isn't it?
Yeah. And they're all watching going, yes, I'll do that too.
Yeah, keep watching because we're going to show you how to change this. But I think it is a very common fault. And I think the thing is that, you know, when we put the ball on the ground, you know, getting the club to approach the golf ball at the right point, it's a hard skill. But we're going to show you how to do that and maybe how you're not quite doing it as you want. So,
and you're a 31 handicap, you say, Nick?
Right,
yeah, 31 handicap. Yeah. And you'll see it's a great golf swing as well. So a couple of changes could make a huge difference today.
Yeah, for sure. All right, let's get you hitting a few of those then. Yep. We're going towards the flag on the 14th. We've got an 8-iron in hand, yeah?
Yep.
As we go through this, hopefully we can...
Very nice. I don't think you're going to be off 31 for long.
No, I don't think so at all. Unless you're a really bad putter.
I am, yeah.
All right, well, let's just show you this first of all. I've got my iPad down there as well. I'm going to go through that as well in a moment. But when you look at that, is there anything that stands out to you?
Maybe my posture a little bit.
Yeah, maybe a bit close to the golf ball. But this is where all the money is going to be made. So if we just look at your setup here, we can see that's a really nice setup when you're facing the golf ball.
Yeah.
When we then get you back down to impact, we're going to find, unfortunately, it's not too dissimilar. If anything, the left arm bends a little bit more. Yeah. You're not really pushing into the left leg and you're not really leaning the shaft forward, which are two main components that we need when we're hitting better irons. Look at where the club hits the ground. So you can see, it's crazy to think that's probably 5 inches before the ball.
It is, yeah.
Now, this shot wasn't terrible.
Yeah.
So you've got a very shallow contact with the ground. I mean, you hitting divots, we can see you've hit some shots already. You're not really taking big divots here. And actually, big divots for you at the moment would be a bad thing. Yeah. But you can see how early you're hitting the ground there.
Yeah.
Now, that's obviously going to influence how well the golf ball is struck.
Yeah.
You, as the ground gets softer as well, you'll know what it's like. You'll be in the summer and you go, my irons are okay in the summer, but in the winter, they're terrible. It's the same swing. The ground is just softer. So what I wanted to do, I asked you earlier about where you practice.
Yep.
So you practice at your driving range, but you have got a grass facility that you can practice at the golf club.
That's right.
If you have got a grass facility where you can go and use and you struggle with your ball striking, go and use that as opposed to using the driving range. So what I'm gonna do, I've got some spray here. We use this to spray the face, but I'm actually gonna use this to spray the ground. So you may have seen us do this before. We do this with everybody. It's just so powerful.
Right.
But what we're going to do is we're going to get you good at striking, if the ball were on the line, either you're going to be striking the line or past the line. That's our focus.
Right.
Whatever
we
do now, whatever I say to you do, your all the time focus is going to be to make sure that you're more past that line. So actually, this is a little bit of a name drop, but we actually filmed with Nick Faldo yesterday, Sir Nick Faldo. And this is a drill that he used to do a lot himself. And it's just, he uses it a lot with golfers he works with as well. And it is very powerful. So we're gonna get you to set up to the line, but what we're gonna do, we're gonna get you from setup to impact. And you can see, look at the things that are happening when I do this. So first of all, I'm turning my body. So you can see I'm turning my hips, my chest is turning a little bit. So I'm turning my body toward the target. I'm also pushing the pressure or the weight into my left leg.
Yep.
So you can see I'm pushing into my left leg. Look at my left arm. It kind of stays straight-ish, but also as a result of that, I'm leaning the shaft forward, okay? So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna get you in here in a moment and get you to replicate this yourself. And anyone watching this as well back home, if you're struggling with your ball striking, get in the garden right now and practice this drill. So set up, and then from there, I'm gonna push and turn my body into my left leg. And I'm almost gonna push the club shaft and try and bend it into the ground, just so I know what it's feel like to get the club pressing into the ground like that. This is a really good awakening of your body for your golf swing, if that makes sense.
Great thing about doing this as well, when Pierce has got the club face against the line, he can make sure the face remains square, so this is really good to enable you to get the club face square as well.
We never want it getting open.
It'll feel quite different as well to do this.
As Andy said, let's make sure first of all we get this squared up, because you've got a beautiful square club face throughout your golf swing.
Right.
I do not want to wreck that. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to help you guide you a little bit here. So I'm just going to hold this. Yep. So if you can just start turning your hips towards the target and push into your left leg. And notice what I'm doing now. I'm actually getting the club and squeezing it into the ground.
Yep.
You'll see how your left arm is pretty straight.
Yep.
You can see how you're leaning the shaft forward. Look what you're doing to the loft. So you're taking the loft off the club face. So you're turning your 8-iron into a 7-iron or even a 6-iron.
Yep.
When you hit the shots, unfortunately, you're kind of returning back with an 8 and maybe even a 9-iron. If you think about when you're hitting here, this is where you're living.
Yeah.
I need you to be more like this now.
Right.
More turn, more turn, more turn. Go on, turn those hips, turn those hips. Beautiful. That feels really weird, doesn't it?
It does, yeah.
Okay.
It's not comfy.
Not comfy, okay. All right, so what we're going to do, please don't swing back and hit, but I want you to press the club into my foot and recreate that impact. Beautiful. Again, look at that club face, Andy. He's keeping it really square, which is very important.
Good. I'm just going to make sure he does it right again. Do that again for us. Start again.
Yeah.
Okay, do it again without moving your head so much towards
good
there.
Man. Right, yeah.
Okay, beautiful. Good.
And this is just something that you can become.
Okay, very nice.
Obsessed is obsessed a bad word to use? I don't think it is.
Not if it's a good thing. Not if it's a good thing. This is where the better ball strikers are at impact. And this is just when you do this drill at home, you're going to go, this feels totally weird. But just rehearsing where we want to be at impact helps us create the impact as well.
You've got to move the practice ball bag without moving your hips, without moving your chest, and with keeping that left arm bent. So have a go moving that for me. Really quite difficult. And you're probably not going to move it when we do it the correct way, but you'll notice how much more power you can put into it. So from now then, so don't move the club, turn your hips towards the target, put the weight into your left leg, and then start leaning and start pushing that back. See how you're bending the shaft a load more now?
Yeah.
So you're creating that power, but as Andy said, we're just going to keep that
head
as you do it. Beautiful. So what I'd like you to do now is to actually have some practice swings, okay?
Yep.
So set up to the line, and all I want you to do is to have a swing back to here, and then you're gonna move towards the target like we've just done. So turn, so start turning your body, start driving forward into the left leg, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, so have some practice swings like that for me. And if we can catch the ground, then great. Good. Okay, good. Again, let's get that length forward there. Go into impact for me again. Replicate it for me, replicate it. Bring the head back. Good man, good man. It's a little bit of like tapping your head and rubbing your tummy.
It is, yeah.
But it's actually, when you get used to it, you'll get it. Okay, right. Have those short practice swings again. Good. You can go a little bit longer on the way back.
Yep.
Good. Right, okay. So now you've got the feel of what's going on here with the body. We're trying to get this move into the left leg, and we're trying to lean the shaft forward. We're trying to turn the body. Now put the focus, the real focus, into striking this line in a good place.
Yep.
So we're aware of what we've done, but really the main thing now is let's get you hitting the line or past it.
Okay.
In those practice swings. Good. See what you're doing here now.
Yeah.
So this is where you were striking adjust. That's where it was. It was probably about there before, wasn't it? Massive difference.
Ooh, so what Pierce is doing now?
Steady on, Andy.
What Pierce is doing now is giving him an external focus.
He can't control himself. Good.
So he's giving the internal focus. What does it feel like? Yeah, okay, I've got an awareness of what the body's doing. Now the focus is external, which is giving him more about actually the ground, which sort of almost takes out the feeling of that. Much better on the golf course to have the external focus. If you haven't got grass practice facilities to do this and spray the line, if you're on the driving range, get a chalk line down there. Get a chalk line, just draw it on the mat, or even get a towel and place it behind. And your job is to miss the towel. It's going to move you in a better way with the body.
So you didn't take a divot, but look at where you hit the ground on this one.
Yeah.
You hit after the line.
Yeah.
Now it's going to be hard when the ball's there. And it's going to take some time, and it's not something that's going to be like, oh, suddenly it's amazing. But I think we can get you a little bit better for sure. All we're going to get you to do now, in fact, if I can just jump in there and just hit one, is that okay?
Yeah.
So you'll see when I'm hitting one now, I'm only wanting to hit this around about 100 yards. That wasn't too bad. It probably was a little bit before. It was pretty much on the line.
Yeah.
But you can see this is the kind of strike point that we're after as opposed to here. So jump in there, jump in there.
Yep.
So have some practice swings here. Give me a couple of practice swings. Again, have a short back swing and a shorter through swing as a result. So it's almost like it's a punch shot under the wind, isn't it? Okay, let's have a go hitting the ball. Okay, nice. So you can see straight away, we've got a little bit of feedback now.
Yeah.
So your line's here, and you were probably 2 inches before it.
Yeah.
But that's better than being...
It's a lot closer.
Yeah, exactly. It's better than being there, isn't it?
Yeah.
Good, and this is where there's just the focus now shifts the motion. So because Nick's there thinking about hitting the golf ball, then the ground, his whole body now is moving this way. And with the irons getting into a position where we've got the weight in this lead leg, pressures here, that is what is really going to separate the poor ball strikers from the great ball strikers. If this is useful, by the way, if you think this drill is going to help you on the range, just hit the thumbs up and leave us a comment down below. What do you struggle with the most in your game? Let us know down below.
Yeah, definitely moving. You literally just took that off the tee. In fact, no, took it off the tee there. You can see, look, flicked a bit of grass up there.
Just a quick one. I think the average before, your average attack angle was 0.4. Right. Which is sort of not much down. That was 1.4 down on that one. So that's the really first one that you've actually got hitting more than 1 degree down with your irons. So you can see the shift on that.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Oh, look at that. Look at
the walk after it as well.
Walk after there as well. I hope you got that, Sean. Yeah,
so here we go.
Massive difference there.
Come and have a look at this. Because you'll see what we've just done there. This is just phenomenal. This is the shot. Let me get my shadow out of the way. This is the shot we've just hit. T was here on the line. Look at the divot. I think the divot was starting after the line in that one.
Looks like it, doesn't
it? It does, doesn't it? Yeah. Let's do it again. Let's prove it wasn't a fluke.
And I love the little walk after it there. That's not a bad thing to do in practice.
Off the deck. We don't need a tee now, do we? And when we're doing this as well, Nick, and anyone watching this at home as well, sometimes we can get a bit obsessed by the line and the ball and hitting down and all that. Sometimes you just need to understand that the ball is just there and we're just in the way. So all you're really trying to say to yourself is, I want the club head to be traveling through the hitting area and just striking in after this line, not really thinking about sort of being hyper-focused on it, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
Just allow your body to turn and move and the ball to get in the way.
Right.
Feedback without looking at the line, don't look.
I think it was all right.
Have a look. So a little bit before still.
Just before, yeah.
Only an inch.
That was nice. So on that one, you can really see how the body's moving towards the target. Now that was 2.3 down on that one.
Okay.
So that was so much better.
Yeah.
And you can just see the intention for you is like, let's just get through.
Yeah.
Let's get onto this left side.
So that's where you're at setup. Are you any different impacts? Look at the backswing, nice and compact. Look at the way you're shifting. Oh my goodness. Look at that.
Yeah.
Look how much more the shaft is lent forward.
It is, yeah.
And you can see, look where you're hitting the ground.
Yeah.
The only thing was you caught it a little bit of the hill. Right, let's hit one more. Again, look at the ball flight. Look at how you're posting up on that left side.
Yeah.
That, sir, is your drill. All right, I hope you enjoyed that. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Leave a comment as well. And also, 5 shots lower. Knock them off your score. Click the link in the description to take advantage of the free video series. We'll see you soon.
Cheers, guys.